Hi, I'm Sari from Sharetribe. In this video, we will change the color of submit buttons in your Sharetribe marketplace. We will modify the button color in the codebase, check our results locally, create a commit and push our changes to the remote repository, and check our results in our deployed website. To follow this tutorial, you will need to be working with a custom hosted version of Sharetribe, as we will be directly customizing the code. We're now viewing the deployed version of your custom code on render. To make these changes, let's open Visual Studio Code. We can now open the folder where our web template is housed, and we can then run the local version of this code by running yarn run dev. This starts the local version on your computer in localhost 3000. The file we will modify will change the login color. So by default, this is how the login button looks like. The same color is used in the submit button on the checkout page and listing page. So the file we're going to modify is in source, styles, it's called marketplace defaults. This is a file that defines a lot of different colors, fonts, and other look-related variables. Marketplace color by default comes from console at the moment, so these colors are not used when the color is defined in console, as it is in our marketplace. In addition, the template defines some colors that have certain functions. This color success indicates that something is working successfully. And this is actually the color in the login button. Color success dark, it's a darker version, and it's the hover color. In addition, this file defines a color fail and a color attention. Color fail just indicates that something is going wrong. Color attention means that something needs the user's attention. The default values for these variables are based on traffic lights. As you can see, red for failure, yellow for attention, and green for success. And it's a good idea if you are modifying these colors to stay pretty close to the traffic light logic so that the functions of the colors remain the same. So if we want to change the color of the submit and login buttons, we're going to change these two colors. You can find these values in the description. And we're going to modify the color success a bit, and then color success dark a bit. So they're still green, but they're a bit bluer green than before. So now this is the default color. As you can see, we haven't yet saved the file. So whenever you see in your file name tab, you see a little circle, it means you haven't saved the file. I will save the file and it started compiling. When you are running the template locally with yarn run dev, all changes are applied instantly. So you don't have to restart the server. Instead, it hotloads the changes. So now we change to this tab and we can see that the color has changed. Awesome. If we go to our web template version, we can see that the color here has not changed, but in our local version, the color has changed. Now we want to get our changes to the deployed version as well. And the way we do this is we commit our changes. So in the sidebar, you can see that now when we saved the file, we have a little one in the source control icon. And when we hover over it, it says one pending changes. Let's include those changes in our code base for real. And in the Git version control system, it means we're going to make a commit. Clicking on the plus sign stages these changes, it means that these are the changes we want to include in this commit. If we had other changes, we could include them in the same commit, or then we can make separate commits for separate changes. Often it is useful to make separate commits for separate changes so that you can see what changed where, in case something goes wrong, in case you need to backtrack from some change. But here we are confident that our change is what we want to do. If you want to see what changed, you can click on this file name on the source control tab, and then you can see on red the things that were removed and in green the things that were added. Next, we can create the commit. We can add a message here. It's useful to have descriptive commit messages, again, so that we know what happened where in case we need to investigate. What we did here is we changed the success color. So let's write that and commit. Now we can see the button says sync changes. And when we hover, it suggests to push one commit to upstream/main. If you remember from our previous video, we now have two remotes. Upstream is the Sharetribe version and origin is our own version. So instead of clicking here, we will push the changes from the terminal. And to see what changes we're pushing, you can type in git log, and then if you add one line, it will show you a single line for each change set or commit. These are the ones that are in upstream main and origin main. These are the ones that are already in our repository. This is the change that we just made, and we can see that it is committed there. You can exit the log by typing in Q. So to push your changes, you can do git push origin. We want to specify that this is in fact the origin where we want to push. And you can also specify the branch. So we made these changes to main. Let's specifically push to main. So type in git push origin main, and it has now pushed it to our repository. Now we can see what that change looks like in the repository. Here, we've pushed it to the web template, and we can see that the most recent change has been our commit to change success color. On the render side, there has been some video magic, and the deploy has started for change success color, and the deploy is now also live for change success color. So we skipped the waiting here. And now if we refresh our page, we can see that the submit button has the new color. You have made your first custom code change to your repository.